أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد. أفضل صلواتك بأعظم معلوماتك وبارك وسلم وصل عليه. آية نمبر 19. أفرأيتم اللات والعزى. Have you then thought about Lat and Uzza? Lat was one statue. Uzza was another statue. Manat was a third statue. Lat, Uzza and Manat. These were three statues. They used to worship them as God. And as we mentioned before, that the people of Peninsula used to call angels as daughters of God. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that angels are a different type of creature. They do not have any gender. You can neither call them men nor women. Neither male nor female. So how do you people call them as the daughters of Allah? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Got it? So the only reason they used to call them as girls, what? The ta in the end. The letter? Ta, malaikatun. The letter ta. In the end, which is the symbol of feminine. In Arabic language, a word which has letter ta in the end, that's a symbol of feminine. So as malaikatun, as ta in the end, they used to call them as girls and daughters of Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that that rule is not applicable everywhere. If that is the case, so your three gods, Lot, has ta in the end. Manat has ta in the end. Uzza has alif maqsura in the end. And ta and alif maqsura both are symbols of feminine. So then you will admit that your gods are woman as well. That your gods are? So they were trapped. People of Peninsula, they were trapped.
أَفَرَأَيْتُمُ اللَّاتَ. Have you then thought of your God Lot? وَالْغُزَّى and another God غُزَّى وَمَنَاتَ and a third one مَنَاتَ الثَّالِثَةَ الْأُخْرَى. Is the other third أَلَكُمُ الذَّكَرُ. Is it for you the males وَلَهُ الْأُنْثَى and for Allah the females.
What are you talking about? You do not accept only one single daughter. You bury her alive. You people, bury her alive. That was the case of the Clipper Peninsula. In so many tribes, that was their tradition. That if a woman delivered a girl, they used to bury her alive. In Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُوتَةُ سُئِلَتْ. When the buried alive daughter would be asked on the day of judgment, بِأَيَّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. That what was your crime that they buried you alive. And there is a story. A Sahabi and companion of Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Somewhere from Peninsula he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He accepted the message. When he was going back, passing by a tribe, they asked him, where do you come from? He told them, I had been there with Muhammad. Peace be upon him and sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they asked him, can you tell us something? What you talked to Muhammad and what he talked to you? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, yes. I told him about our traditions, about our culture, about our customs and usages. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and God Almighty blessed us with your message. Yes, otherwise we were lost people. We were wild. We were wild people. You came and you brought us back to humanity. Are to humanitarian values and norms. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I told him, that O the Messenger of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we were burying our daughters alive. Prophet asked him, why? He said, لِأَنَّهُنَّ لَا يَقْدِرْنَ عَلَى الْقَتْلِ وَالْغَارَى. Because kids are children. We use to have children for two purposes. Number one, to earn. What? To earn. And number two, to fight. Daughter and a daughter, she does not earn, nor she fights. Got it? So she was an economical burden. That's why you are not accepting her. So whenever a woman delivered a baby, girl baby, we used to bury her alive. Prophet asked me, have you done also? Do you attend? I said to the messenger of Allah, let me tell you one story. I'm a businessman. I was going on a business trip to Rome, where, to Italy, and my wife was pregnant. My wife was pregnant. I told her, if you deliver a son, take care of it. If that's a daughter, so don't bring me a bad name. Just bury her alive as soon as possible. She said, after a few months when I came back, the first ever thing I asked my wife about delivery, she said, that was a dead baby. It was a dead baby. Okay. Done. He said, days were passing. One day he came to my house, a very pretty girl of 6-7 years old. She rushed to me and she hugged me and she said, Ya Abata, dead? Yes. Hearing a word of dead from a girl, I became crazy. What's this? And my wife, she came to me and she was crying. That this is the same baby I delivered in your absence. I was taking care of her. I never told you. She was very pretty. I was unable to bury her alive. I said, may Allah and God Almighty curse you. You brought a bad name to me. You brought a bad name to me. I took that girl to a desert. I threw her in a trench. And when I was putting dust on her, she was crying. And she was asking me, Ya Abata, Ayya Zulmin Zalam Istauduni, what crime I have done or I have committed, why you are burying me? And he told their tribe, when I related their story to Prophet Muhammad, he broke in tears. That what a barbarism that was. What a cruelty that was. Why you people were doing that? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you are not ashamed of what you are saying, O people of Peninsula, attributing all these angels as daughters to Allah, and you yourself cannot adopt or accept only one daughter, you bury her alive.
Is it for you the males or the women's sign, for Allah the females? Tilkaizan kismatun diza, that indeed is a division most unfair.
That most unjust division or distributing you are doing. You are not taking only one girl for yourself, and these billions and billions of angels you do attribute to Allah as his daughter. You are not ashamed of what you are saying.
Tilkaizan kismatun diza, this is indeed a division most unjust and unfair. إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا أَسْمَاءٌ سَمَّيْتُمُوهَا. These are nothing but only names, سَمَّيْتُمُوهَا, which you have named.
Your gods are nothing but only names, only, and claims you have made it. That this God, he will give me this thing. This God, he will help me like this. This God, he will remove this hardship and difficulty of mine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that your imagination only. It has nothing to do with reality.
إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا أَسْمَاءٌ سَمَّيْتُمُوهَا. They are but names which you have named, أَنْتُمْ يُوْ وَآبَاؤُكُمْ and your forefathers. مَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ بِهَا مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ, for which Allah has not sent down any authority.
Who told you that Allah is God? Who told you that Manat is God? Do you have any basis for? Any evidence? Any written document? Do you have any proof for? No? Only your imagination.
مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ بِهَا مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ, Allah has not sent down any authority regarding this. إن يتبعون إلا الظن they follow but a guess and imagination of their وما تهوى الأنفس and they with themselves desire
they follow their imagination and their desires only.
وَلَقَدْ جَاءَهُمْ مِنْ رَبِّهِمُ الْهُدَىٰ and there has come to them a guidance from their Lord
in shape of the Holy Book and in shape of Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَهُمُ الْهُدَىٰ and there has come to them a guidance in shape of the Holy Quran and in shape of Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him.
أَمْ لِلْإِنسَانِ مَا تَمَنَّا أَرْسَلْ مَنْ هَوْ what he wishes.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, man is free, but not great free. Freedom has limits as well. Freedom has limits. Yes, you can speak. You can, but you cannot abuse me. You know what I'm saying? You can run, but you cannot hit or push me. As I told you, there's one guy, yes, but he was doing? He was spinning a a stick in his finger and he hit the nose of someone beside him. Yes. With the stick. So that guy became crazy. Are you crazy? You hit my nose. He said, this is my freedom. I'm a free man. You cannot put restriction to this finger of mine. You know what I'm saying? That guy said a very golden sentence. That your freedom ends where from my nose begins. Your freedom ends where from my nose begins. Yes, you can do that, but don't hit my nose. Your freedom just starts here. God is the professor. Yes. So there is no any concept of unlimited freedom anywhere. Yes, that's unnatural. That's illogical. That's unreasonable. Is it or not? Yes.
أَمْ لِلْإِنسَانِ مَا تَمَنَّا أَرْ شَلْ مَنْ هَيْوَ جِيْوِشِزْ
Allah asked, shall man have the right to say or to do what he wishes? No. He is subject to Allah. He is subject to God. He must find out what's allowed and permissible and what's not.
أَمْ لِلْإِنسَانِ as we say,
they do not put a question mark where God Almighty has put it. Period. Where Allah has put a period, don't put a question mark here. Just stop here.
أَمْ لِلْإِنسَانِ مَا تَمَنَّا أَرْسَلْ مَنْ هَيْوَ what he wishes فَلِلَّهِ الْآخِرَةُ but to Allah belongs الْآخِرَةُ the hereafter وَالْأُولَى and this world.
This world belongs to Allah and the hereafter belongs to Allah. When Allah is the owner of this world and the hereafter, so everybody in this world is subject to the will of Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes? And subject to the approval of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he will not obey his order, he would be punished accordingly. Living here in America, we are subject to constitution. Yes? We are subject to every single law implemented here. If somebody will violate this, he will face the consequences. If you are not living in America, that's something else. But if you are living here, you are subject to every single law implemented here in America. Yes? So Allah says, if you are not living in the world of Allah, you are not subject to Allah. Yes. But if you are living in the state of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are subject to Allah then. You cannot violate the rule. If you will violate, you will face the consequences. Something logical.
أَمْ لِلْإِنسَانِ مَا تَمَنَّا أَرْ شَلْ مَنْ هَيْوَ what he wishes?
No. Shall man have what he wishes? No. There are certain restrictions to his wishes. Certain restrictions are there to his wishes.
فَلِلَّهِ الْآخِرَةُ but to Allah belongs الْآخِرَةُ the hereafter وَالْأُولَىٰ and this world.
So whatever you are doing here, you would be held responsible for that in the hereafter. Just write it down. That the ayah or the verse means, whatever you are doing here, you would be held responsible for that in the hereafter. This world is gone. World of actions. This world is gone. World of actions. And hereafter is God, the world of recompense. That is the world of recompense. If your actions are good, recompense will be a reward. If your actions are bad, recompense will be a punishment. That is something very reasonable, intellectual, logical. Yes or not? Observe. This is or not?
وَكَمْ مِنْ مَلَكٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ And there are many angels in the heavens. لَا تُغْنِي شَفَاتُهُمْ شَيْئًا Whose intercession will avail nothing. إِلَّا مِنْ بَارِ أَيَّاذَنَ اللَّهِ Except after that Allah has given a leave. لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَرْضَى For whom He will then please it.
So write down later. No intercession will avail anything on the day of judgment. Nobody can intercede. But with the leave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But with the leave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So someone who believes in a specific messenger in his time, in a specific messenger in his time, the messenger concerned will intercede for his followers. That is with the leave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him, he will intercede for all of us. That these are my followers. They said la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. They have a contact with you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through me. A contact with you through me. That there is no God but only Allah and Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Yes. They have some bad or evil deeds, but I do intercede. Please forgive them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, okay, forgive us.
وَكَمْ مِنْ مَلَكٍ And there are many angels فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ In the heavens لَا تُغْنِي شَفَاتُهُمْ شَيْئًا Whose intercession will avail nothing إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ أَنْ يَعْظَنَ اللَّهُ But after that Allah has given leave لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَرْضَى For whom He wills and pleases إِنَّ الَّذِينَ Indeed those لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ Who do not believe in the hereafter لَيُسَمُّونَ الْمَلَائِكَةَ They name the angels تَسْمِيَةَ الْأُنْثَى With female names
So who told them that angels are female? Yes, can we decide that this pillar, the arch pillar, is a male or female? It does not have any gender. This pillar does not have any gender. Neither we can call it male nor female. So Allah says that angels, they do not have gender. Why do you call them female?
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ indeed those لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ do not believe in the hereafter لَيُسَمُّونَ they name الْمَلَائِكَةَ the angel تَسْمِيَةَ الْأُنْثَى with by the names of female or female names وَمَا لَهُمْ بِعِلْمٍ why they have no knowledge of that إِنْ يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ they follow not but their guess and imagination
conjecture what Conjecture. They follow not but only their own imagination and conjecture.
They follow not but only their own conjecture. وَإِنَّ الظَّنَّ لَا يُغْنِي مِنَ الْحَقِّ شَيْئًا And an imagination cannot substitute for the truth.
Imagination cannot change it because facts are sacred. Facts are, if I will close my eyes and I will say, this is 9:15 in the morning and the sun is there very much shining. Yes. Now this is my imagination. It has nothing to do with the reality. It cannot change the reality. This is night time and 9:15 in the evening. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says if people of peninsula, they will close their eyes and they will say angels are female and they are the daughters of Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fact is that they don't have gender. Got it? So your imagination has nothing to do with the reality.
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ indeed those لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ who believe not in the hereafter لَيُسَمُّونَ الْمَلَائِكَةَ they name the angels تَسْمِيَةَ الْأُنْثَى with female names وما لهم به من علم while they have no knowledge thereof. إن يتبعون إلا الظن they follow but against an imagination وإن الظن لا يغني من الحق شيئا and yet is no substitute for the truth or
against our imagination cannot counter the truth and reality. It cannot compete the truth and reality. And based upon this ayah, Abu Hanifa rahimahullah introduced the ethical issue. If someone remembers that he made wudu, if somebody remembers that he made wudu, and later on he has a doubt, my wudu is broken or not? My wudu, there's a doubt. That wudu is broken. Yes, he remembers that he made wudu, but he does not remember that his wudu is broken. So Abu Hanifa says, rahimahullah, his wudu is not broken. He should pray. Because, inna zanna la yughni min al-haqq shay'a. Doubt cannot compete the fact. It cannot counter the fact. It cannot break the fact. So fact is that you have made wudu, which you remember. But you do not remember that your wudu is broken. You have only a doubt. So just go ahead and pray. Got it? So that issue, fiqh issue is derived from this ayah of Surah An-Najm.
إِنَّ الظَّنَّ لَا يُغْنِي مِنَ الْحَقِّ شَيْئًا Indeed, digest and imagination or conjecture is no substitute to a truth. فَعَارِضْ هَمَّنْ تَوَلَّى Therefore, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم withdraw from someone who turns away from our reminder.
Holy Quran, someone who is a stubborn, hard-headed guy. Stubborn. As I mentioned, that there are two types of people. People do not believe properly either because of ignorance or because of arrogance. There are two things. Someone does not believe in the message of Muhammad because he is ignorant. And someone does not believe, he knows but he is arrogant. He doesn't want to. So the first one, you can guide him. The second one, you are wasting your time with. Because he is arrogant. He will never listen to you. Got it? So that was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that hard-headed guy you may not waste your time with. Ahar is one man tawalla han zikrina. Arrogancy, who turned away from Holy Quran, he doesn't listen to you, don't waste your time with such like guys. Got it? Professor, got it?
فَعَارِفْ هَمَّنْ تَوَلَّا So turn away هَمَّنْ from that one تَوَلَّا خَنْ ذِكْرِنَا Withdraw from that one تَوَلَّا خَنْ ذِكْرِنَا Who turns away from our reminder the Holy Quran وَلَمْ يُرِدْ إِلَّا الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا And he desire nothing but only the life of this world.
He is not thinking about hereafter. So somebody is not thinking about hereafter. And he said, Kao piyo, or mother or aho. They eat and drink and enjoy your life. Eat and drink and enjoy your life. Do you believe in life after death? If somebody does not believe in life after death, and he does not believe in the existence of God, so with such like people, you will be wasting your time only. Got it?
فَعَارِضْ هَمَّنْ تَوَلَّا خَنْ ذِكْرِنَا بِتْلَا فْرَمْ تَيْتْ وَنْ هُو turned away from our reminder, Holy Quran. وَلَمْ يُرِدْ وَلَمْ يُرِدْ إِلَّا الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا And he doesn't want but only the life of this world. ذَلِكَ مَبْلَغُهُمْ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ That is what they could reach of knowledge.
That is their approach. That is their approach is very limited. Their approach is they are not far-sighted people. Because those who are thinking of the life of this world only and do not believe in the hereafter. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says their approach is very limited approach. They are not far-sighted people. Got it? Yes.
ذَلِكَ مَبْلَغُهُمْ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ That is what they could reach of knowledge. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ وَرِلِي يُوَرْ لَادُ وَمُحَمَّدْ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَعَالَمُ هِ نُوْضُ مَنْ ضَلَّ خَنْ سَبِيلِ That one who has gone astray of the path of Allah وَهُوَ عَالَمُ بِمَنِ اتَدَى And he knows best. That one who receives guidance. وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ and to Allah belongs all there in the heavens وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ and all there in the earth.
What is there in the heavens? It belongs to Allah. What is there on the earth? It belongs to Allah. Because nobody, even the disbeliever, someone who does not believe in the existence of God even, he cannot say that I have created this thing. Nobody can say that the whole world is created by Allah only.
وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ and to Allah belongs all that which is there in the heavens وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ and all that which is there on the earth لِيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا the ultimate justice لِيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِمَا عَمِلُوا that he may recompense those who do evil لِيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسَاءُوا بِمَا عَمِلُوا that he may recompense those who did evil بِمَا عَمِلُوا with they have done وَيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا بِالْحُسْنَى and he may reward those who did good with what they have done الَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ
those who have done good deeds. Who are these people?
الذين تأذوا يجتنبون كبائر الإثم who avoid
major sins who avoid major sins كبائر الإثم who avoid major sins
والفواحش and evil deeds
major sins and evil deeds
إلا لمن except the small parts
which happens accidentally except the small faults which happen accidentally. So those who are trying not to commit any major sin or crime and not to practice any evil deed but only small faults which happens accidentally or ignorantly. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they are good guys. They are good guys.
الَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ كَبَائِرَ الْإِثْمِ those who avoid kabair al-ithmi major sins wal-fawahisha and evil deeds illa lamam except the small parts happen accidentally
or ignorantly. Surah An-Nisa
in tajtanibu kabair ma tunhawna if you avoid the major sins
got it?
If you avoid the major sins on hauna ghanhu, which you are forbidden to do, nukaffir ghanhum sayyatikum, we shall remit your small sins, wa nudkhilukum mudkhalan kareema, and we will so take you to a noble entrance paradise.
If you will avoid the major sins, so small parts, which happen ignorantly or accidentally, we will forgive you. And we will take you to paradise. But try not to commit any major sin.
Now sins are of two types.
We should write it.
Small and major. And the scholars, they have different views in this regard. That what a sin would be called or named is a major sin. So Ibn Abbas says, that wherever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited a thing expressly,
that is major sin. That is what? Major sin.
Number two, not to practice a mandatory practice or an important one for us are wajib. That a major sin is as well.
If somebody does not pray or did not pray Salat al-Maghrib, that's a major sin. Yes. He did not fast in the month of Ramadan, that's a major sin.
Now Ibn Abbas says, radiyallahu ta'ala an, major sins are 70 in number.
70.
And Sa'id ibn Jubair says,
they are 700, not only 70.
A scholar, his name is Abu Talib Makki,
a well-known scholar of Islamic Sharia,
or Islamic law. Abu Talib, Makki.
He says the details of major sins are as follow. Number one, four sins are related to your tongue,
which somebody commits by tongue.
Number one, any lie.
That's a major sin.
Number two, sihr, to bewitch someone.
To bewitch someone with certain words.
Number three, to take an oath falsely.
He is lying and taking oath, which is called perjury. What's called what?
Perjury. That's a major sin. Number four, to put false charges against someone.
That's a major sin.
And all these four types are related to tongue. Four are related to heart. Number one, to believe in associate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
To believe in someone else as God or Lord.
Number two, to give up his hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Someone who gave up his hope in the mercy of Allah.
Number three, someone who does not have the fear of the punishment of Allah. Number four, having a strong will to violate the rule of Allah.
Having a strong will or intention to violate the rule of Allah.
Three others are related to your stomach. Number one, drinking alcoholic drinks. Number two, interest and usury. And number three, taking away the property of an orphan.
Taking up the property of an orphan. That's a major sin.
Two are related to hands. Number one, killing someone for no reason.
That's a major sin.
And number two, stealing or committing theft. That's a major sin. Two are related to private parts of body. Number one, adultery, fornication, and rape.
That's the major sin.
Adultery,
yes,
which is the evil practice by someone who is married. Fornication, by someone who is not married. And rape, by force. In first two, maybe there is mutual consent, but that's a major sin. It's not allowed. Yes? And in rape, there is force. So all three are major sins. Adultery, fornication, and rape. And you know the expression? You knew it? You got it or not?
Yes.
And number two, sodomy. Sexual relation of male with male. And one is related to your legs. Running away off the battlefield when it is needed.
When battle is unavoidable, you have to protect your country. You have to protect your honor. You have to protect your dignity. You have to protect your property. You have to protect your belief. And in battlefield, someone ran away, so that is a major thing. Now you got it or not it? So go back to your sabak.
الذين ذو جتنبونا هو avoid كبائر الاسم major sins والفوائش والفوائش and evil deeds إلا اللمم but only small parts
which happen accidentally or ignorantly.
إن ربك indeed your Lord is واسع المغفرة. Your Lord is of vast forgiveness.
Your Lord is of vast forgiveness.
Huwa alamu bikum. He knows you very well. Is anshaakum because he has created you. Min al arzi from the earth.
Allah has created you from the earth. So he knows you. He knows our origin. He knows our origin.
Huwa alamu bikum. Allah knows you very well. Is anshaakum min al-arzi because he created you people min al-arzi from
dust, from earth. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam? Prophet Muhammad says, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah ordered Archangel Jibreel to rake the surface of the globe, to rake with his right hand. And he did it. And his right hand is hand. Yes. Because his body covered the whole horizon. The whole horizon was covered by the body of Archangel Jibreel. So think about his hand. It's not like our hand. It's a hand as big as this world. So he raked the surface of the globe. Yes. And then it was raining upon this dust, which was just like a fire. It was just like a fire. It was raining upon there for 40 years. And Ibn Abbas says, big horses, but big horses, they were jumping in their mud to make it a dough. To make it what? A dough. So big horses, because dinosaurs were not known to the people of Arabia. So Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he would have said, dinosaurs were jumping there in their mud to make it a dough. So people would be asking, what is dinosaur? Have you ever seen someone? You know what I'm saying? So to make it easy, yes, Ibn Abbas used the word, what? Big horses. Big horses. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the structure of Adam from the same mud. So Allah is referring to,
Huwa alamu bikum, he knows you very well. Is anshaakum min al-arzi because he created you people min al-arzi from the earth. Wa is antum ajinnatum fi butuni ummahatikum. And when you are fetuses in the womb of your mother.
So as far as your origin is concerned, Adam, Allah created him from mother, so he knows your origin. Yes. And he knows everyone since that time. When he was in shape of fetus in the womb of his mother. When he was in shape of fetus in the womb of his mother. So Allah says, your origin is known to me. Your person is known to me since that time when you were in shape of fetus. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, now don't make that claim. I know your origin. I know you since that time when you were in shape of fetus. Now you are making false claim.
فلا تزكوا أنفسكم so never claim cleanliness for yourself. وعالموا Allah knows very well بمن اتقى that one who is pious. أفرأيت الذي تولى. Have you seen O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم that one تولى who turned away from your message and from Holy Quran.
Have you thought about him? Have you observed him? Have you seen him?
أَفَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي have you seen that one? The one who turned away from your message, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَعْتَى قَلِيلًا and he gives a little. وَأَقْضَى and then stopped giving.
He gives the letter. He will send me. He is very...
So number one, he does not believe in your message. He does not believe in your message. And number two, in practice he is very stingy. So what a guy who does not have neither a belief nor action. Neither a belief nor action.
أَفَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي have you observed that one. تَوَلَّا who turned away from your message of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم وَآتَا قَلِيًا and he gave a little وَأَكْدَى and then he stopped giving. أَعِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ الْغَيْبِ is with him the knowledge of the unseen فَهُوَ يَرَى so that he sees there from.
He has some unseen knowledge which you do not.
أَمْ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ الْغَيْبِ is with him is the knowledge of unseen فَهُوَ يَرَى so that he sees there from. أَمْ لَمْ يُنَبَّى or is he not informed بِمَا فَيْسُهُ فِي مُوسَى with what is there in the pages and scripture of Moses, Old Testament. أَمْ لَمْ يُنَبَّى or he has not been informed بِمَا فَيْسُهُ فِي مُوسَى in that message which was there in the scripture of Moses, Old Testament.
He doesn't know what was the message in scripture of Moses about you. In Old Testament, you are mentioned, O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes. Look at me. A convert brother. A brother who converts to Islam. He has written a book. Yes. One I put here, I don't know who has taken it away. I put one here. And then the brother or sister, they do not ask me. I put books here for brothers to study. If someone will ask me, I am taking it, I will bring it back. Okay, just take it. But if there is only one copy, so then everybody should think about that, that I may not take it to my house. Got it? So he has written a book. And in that book, he has written the pages of the scripture of Abraham and the pages of the scripture of original book of Moses. And the pages of the original gospel of Jesus. Alayhim salawat wa taslimat peace be upon all of them. That what all these books said about Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's what Allah is referring to.
Am lam yunabba bima feso fe Musa are his he not informed with what is there in the scripture of Moses, Old Testament. وإبراهيم الذي وفى and in the scripture of Abraham who fulfilled all that what Allah ordered him. Allah تذر وازرة وزر أخرى that no burdened person shall bear the burden of another on the day of judgment.
But that is mentioned here. A father cannot avail anything to his son. And same is the case vice versa. كل نفس بما كسب رهين. Every individual would be held responsible for his own good or wrongdoing. Every individual, he would be held responsible for his own good or wrongdoing.
Allah tazeru waziraton izra ukhra that no burdened person with sin shall bear the burden of sins of another. Wa allaysa lil insani and that a man can have nothing. Illa ma tagha but only that what he has done
good or bad.
Wa anna sayahu sawfa yura and that his deed will be seen on the day of judgment.
On the day of judgment his deed would be seen.
ثُمَّ يُجْزَاهُ الْجَزَاءَ الْأَوْفَى and then he will be recompensed with a full and the best recompense. وَأَنَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ الْمُنْتَهَىٰ and there the ultimate return is to your Lord for your accountability.
That everybody would be taken back to the Lord of the universe for his accountability. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على رسول محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم ربنا ارحمنا بالقرآن العظيم ونفعنا بالقرآن ما نسينا وعلمنا من ما جهلنا وسنة رمضان علينا وانا النهار. فالله خير الحمد.